Ravish from the Code City, and today we will be learning about automatic task scheduling using Cron jobs and Cron tabs in Linux. So first of all, we need to SSH into our server, and I've already done that. So let's first check if you have Cron installed or not. So first of all, type Cron tab dash L. So it is showing no Cron tab for root. That's because I have not set up any Cron jobs for the root user. If you are showing no command Cron tab add, Cron tab found, you need to install Cron tab. So if you are running Ubuntu, any Debian systems, you need to write apt get install cron, or if you are using Red Hats, you can do yum install cron. So that's all. After you have installed, you are ready to go. So first thing is, to create a cron job, you need to write the command cron tab dash e. What it does is it creates a cron tab for the current user. So I'm logged in as root, so cron tab for the root user will be created. If you are logged in as another user, a cron tab for another user will be created. So I'll just show you what happens. So I hit enter. I see this file, and I can write my instructions that I need to execute at a specific interval of time here, and then it will be executed at that time. So right now I'm going to exit. And now another thing is, there's a system-wide cron tab, and it is saved in /etc/crontab. So what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to create any specific cron tab for our user. I'm going to create a system-wide cron tab that is inside /etc/crontab. So I'm going to edit it. You see, I already have this thing here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to delete this at the moment, and I'm going to show you what the meaning of all this thing is first. First of all, we can see, first of all, there are five asterisks. Let me explain though what is the meaning of these asterisks. Now, these asterisks, first asterisk is the minute. So here we can see 52.6. This means 52nd minute of the 6th hour. So this job will run every 6:52 a.m. So first asterisk is for minute, second asterisk is for hour, the third asterisk is for the day of month. So you can run tasks on specific month days, like I can write 14th or 15th or 1st. So this is the day of month. So if I write 1, it will be executed on the 1st of every month. Now this fourth asterisk is the month of year. I can write Jan or February or March here, and it will be executed on the 1st of that month. Now the final one is your day of week. So if I write Sunday, it will just be executed on the first minute of Sunday. If I write Monday, it will be executed on Monday, and that's all. So it's pretty simple. So again, we can go over what we went to. The first asterisk is for minute, the second is for hour, the third is for... So now we have understood what the first five asterisks are. Now let's see what we do after that. After that, I'm writing root. So root is a user as which we will be running the commands. So I'm writing root at the moment because I am accessing the cron tab inside the etc folder. You need to be a root user to access this. If you do not have root access, then you cannot access this. If you are not the root user, then you have to do what I have shown in the beginning. Just write cron tab, not here in the terminal, not in this file, and cron tab dash e. Using this command, you will be able to access cron tab for your file, for your specific user. So, but now I am root, so I'll just write root. After that, now this is the command section. You know, right here, you write what commands to run, what instructions to run. So let's say I have a script folder in the root directory, and after that I have simple monitor script. So this is it. Now this is how you run definacron. So as of now, I have no hours, minutes, day of month, month of year, or day of week defined. So what these five asterisks mean is it will run every minute. So my monitor.sh script will run every minute. So all the instructions in this monitor script will run every minute. Please check out the description below. There are a lot of time interval and a lot of time sets that you can do using cron jobs. So this is it for this tutorial. Hit thumbs up if you like this. Maybe share or subscribe. And if you have any doubts, feel free to comment below. I'll try to answer to the best of my knowledge. See you next time.